The Toyota Tacoma and its SUV sibling, the Toyota 4Runner, are renowned for their off-road performance. People around the country love these vehicles, and they add modifications, and they take them to places like where we're going, Moab, Utah, and Ouray, Colorado. We're gonna see just how good these vehicles are off-road, and we're also gonna look at a couple of changes they've made this year to make them better daily drivers. But before we get into that, remember to use Edmunds next time you're ready to buy a truck or SUV, and remember to click subscribe for more videos like this one. There's a lot that goes into good off-road performance, but some of the most basic elements you can actually see just by looking at a vehicle. Take the Tacoma here. It's got a really generous approach angle, and the TRD Off-Road and TRD Pro models don't have an air dam like the SR5 and the Limited, and so there's even extra clearance right in front of the tire if you need to get up onto a rock. Moving to the middle, the frame is tucked up really high, as is the body. That makes it a little bit of a step to get in, but it gives you more clearance underneath when you're off-road. And then in the back, it's got a really good departure angle. The bumper's nice and tidy, and the spare tire is really tucked up high up against the bottom of the bed where it doesn't hang down. And then if you look in along the axle, the shock absorbers are pushed out towards the tires so they don't represent another point that might contact a rock if you straddle something. One of the biggest complaints about the Tacoma was its driving position and the seat that wasn't adjustable. Well, now it is. They've added a 10-way power adjustable seat. So it actually starts out a half inch lower than it was before, which is great for me because I'm tall, but it also goes up 2 inches from there. So if you're not tall, you can raise it up so you can really see out over the hood. And then the front edge of this, because it's 10-way, you can move it up and down to vary the thigh support. I really notice a difference with this new power seat. I could never quite get comfortable in a Tacoma before. One thing that they haven't changed is the steering wheel doesn't telescope out as much as I'd like, but the seat really does make a big difference, and now I think I could drive this cross country and wouldn't have any problems. The other thing they've done is they've increased the thickness of the side glass in an attempt to reduce the amount of wind noise that you hear when cruising on the freeway at speed. We're not going fast enough to know the difference right now, but certainly in other cars where that change has been made, it's proven to be very effective. The Tacoma's powertrain is not its strong point. The 3.5 liter V6 and 6-speed automatic combination doesn't ever quite feel as willing as some of its competitors, and the transmission seems to like to be in sixth gear a little bit more often than it should. That can lead to hunting on slight grades where you wouldn't think it would be necessary. They've changed the shift timing to help alleviate that, and it seems to have worked. I found myself pretty content to leave it in the normal mode and not go for the ECT power button nearly as often. That doesn't mean that it's got any more horsepower and torque than it had before. It doesn't. It's just that what it's got, the transmission is just using a little bit more wisely than before. One of the things I really like about this year's Tacoma is they've added a trail camera, and that's really useful off-road. Push a button to the left of the steering wheel and you get forward views. In this case, I'm in low range, so I have a view to the front and views to the side. There are little prediction lines that show where my tires are going to go, so I can plot my course around a rock. If I want to see a bigger version of this, I just touch it and I swap out to a big front view and diminished side views. There's an auto button here that if I press it will allow the image to come on whenever my speed drops below a certain threshold, so I don't have to keep re-engaging it. And if I drive around in four high, the configuration of these images changes to something that's more suitable for use in a parking lot. So it's a great feature, and it's been enabled by this new touchscreen they've added this year. The off-road controls in the Tacoma haven't really changed, but that's okay because we really like them. This rotary knob puts it in four-wheel drive, this locks the diff, and this knob does crawl control or multi-terrain select. And what's nice about these is they're out of the way, they're not going to rob space that you might need for everyday tasks. Speaking of everyday tasks, one of the things that they've changed is they put in a really nice 8-inch touchscreen audio system. There's buttons here instead of the touchpads we had before. It's much easier to use without taking your eyes off the road. And the best part is they've added Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, which it sorely needed. To use CarPlay, you plug in your phone here to this USB port. There are two more in the center console. They're for power only. Push the home button, push Apple CarPlay, and now you see the familiar interface. You can control your music however you would in any other car. What's nice about this application, though, is if I'm in an area where I don't have signal and can't use Apple Maps, I can use the native maps, but still listen to my music on Apple CarPlay. That's not always possible on every implementation that other manufacturers may have. So this is a really well integrated system, and I really like it. You can't believe how steep this section is. Well, you might be able to tell by looking at the scenery behind me, but we're just going up right straight up a fin of slick rock, which is just sandstone. You know, it's like driving on sandpaper. Definitely some tricky maneuvering, but I could actually see the trail ahead of me, even though I was cresting something, because of these new camera views. And the throttle control in low range is so good in the Tacoma. You know, we've noticed this before in other off-road tests we've done. You know, the powertrain isn't the best on the highway, but when you get it off-road, the throttle response is really delicate, and it really is easy to control your speed. And we're at the top. Now we're going up and down these fins. I think we're on rock, so I've selected rock. Now I'm going to put the crawl control in the lowest speed. And I'm going to take my foot off the brake and just let the vehicle go down. Ooh, that doesn't sound good, but that's what it's doing. Maybe I'm going to shut that off. So right now I can easily see the trail, even though I can't see the trail using this camera. Work the brake going down here. It's real easy. This is a pretty steep drop. The brake control is really easy, and I've got lots of grip, so it's not bad doing it manually. And it's more fun, right? That wasn't so bad at all. I also had a chance to drive the new 4Runner. Like the Tacoma, it's largely the same as the vehicle we already know, but it too has been improved with targeted upgrades. It already had a power adjustable seat, and it didn't get the Tacoma's trail camera system, but it has been given a similar touchscreen audio system upgrade that supports Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, as well as some active safety gear that the Tacoma already had. The main difference is the frame is shorter. It has a shorter wheelbase, which gives it a better breakover angle even than the Tacoma over a lot of these ledges. And then the rear suspension is a 5-link coil spring solid axle instead of leaf spring solid axle. And that gives it a little better articulation. So this is just a little bit better off-road. Even though the Tacoma does well, these do better. The other thing that's really nice about this vehicle is you can get something called KDSS, and that stands for Kinematic Dynamic Suspension System, and that's a fancy acronym that basically means it has a system of stabilizer bars that automatically disconnect themselves when you get on a frame twist section like we're about to be right now. A big advantage in a couple of ways. Obviously, off-road articulation is one of them, but the other one is if you have disconnecting stabilizer bars for off-road, then you can make them really big so that the vehicle doesn't roll very much when you're on a paved mountain road. And so it helps on the road too. So, you know, it's good for both. And if you never go off-road, you might want it, but it is an option. And it's not on every one you're gonna see on the dealer lot. One of the things that's nice is we're in a TRD off-road, and a TRD off-road comes with a rear locking diff. And I just pressed the button to get over this tough spot where one of the wheels came off the ground, and I didn't have great traction. So it's nice to be able to have that in your toolbox in case you need it. Yeah, so the button is up here, and you just have to stop, press the button, and give it a second or two, and then move on. The other thing about the 2024 Runner is they finally added Toyota Safety Sense, which means automated emergency braking, adaptive cruise control, and all that other safety gear that's standard on all other Toyotas. The 4Runner was the last one to get it, but at least it now has it. Wow, that was amazing. You know, the trucks did great. The scenery was incredible. I mean, it still is. Just look at that. The changes, they're pretty subtle, the seat, the head unit, but these are things you're gonna notice every day. They're gonna make this truck easier to live with in between visits to places like this. So yeah, it's all a big win for me. It's still a great truck. It's still the Tacoma we know and love. It's just a little bit better. So if you wanna learn more about this truck, it's gonna come out in the fall. We don't know the pricing just yet, but if you follow along on Edmunds.com, you'll learn those details as soon as we know them. And if you want to see more videos like this, click subscribe.